types of penguin around the world. Not all penguins come from the icy Antarctic. In fact, they are found in a wider range of climates than any other bird or animal groups in the world. The traditional-looking penguins you normally see in television films are called emperor penguins. They live in the South Pole and are the largest of all the penguin family and can grow to nearly 1 meter tall. The smallest penguins are of course called the little penguin. Little penguins are found in Australia and New Zealand and are only around 33 centimeters tall.
That's why you win, guys. Why? Why, guys?
You may have seen it before today. All of our penguins are penguins that originate from Peru and Chile. And of course, say hello to Chili and her friends at Paultons Penguin Feeding Time.
Hello everybody, good afternoon and welcome to the first Penguin Talk of the day. My name is Catherine, I'm the keeper here at Paultons. I'm here to tell you a little bit more about these humbug penguins. So here at Paultons, we do have a colony of 16 humbug penguins, and they get their name from a current that runs from the Antarctic up to the equator near Peru and Chile, where these guys are found in the wild. Now because of these cold seas that they like to swim in, and the hot sun they face when they are on land, they have adapted themselves really, really well to handle both temperatures. So the first adaptation they have is a ball hat at the base of their beak, which you may be able to see if they keep their heads out long enough for you to see. So this ball hat is quite a nice pinky reddy colour. Can they get a bit hot?
No.
So this is what is completely normal. It does not really work. It only gets a bit warm, but actually it's going to be red. And it's just provided as well as a pretty sensitive skin to help cool the barrel. These guys have three layers of feathers. So the first layers of feathers you can't see, they're very tightly compacted together to help keep the cold air out of the warm air in. And then your third layer of feathers, you can't see.
There's some fish on the floor, they're not eating it.
Where?
On the floors.
Oh, yeah.
So many.
Not enough penguin.
Come on, then, Mr. What should we go do now?
They get rid of all the unbroken feathers from the previous year, ready for the classic black and white colour that you may see on a lot of the penguins in the pool already. So these guys on the back, they look a lot, looking really fluffy, but they are not chicks, they are quite old now. They are in their teens. But they are getting ready to get rid of all those old feathers that are quite fluffy. And as I said, they will go back to this black and white natural colour. So I was able to identify Lunch, not only because she is looking a little brown on the neck at the moment, but because they have coloured wing tags. Now we use the coloured wing tags because their natural way of identifying these guys, which is through the spot patterns on their tummies, is quite hard to see when they're in the pool, and if they are on land, they do move a little bit when we go on the islands, so it is very hard to see. But these spot patterns are unique to each of our individual penguins, not one of them are the same, just like you and I will have our own fingerprints. But as I said, are very hard to spot and figure out who is who. So important, we do use wing tags. All the bubble wings will have a single tag on their right or left wing. And then on the other side, we'll have this colour wing, colour tag. So we actually have a colour left wing. So if you do see a blue tag on a left wing, then that is 100% right. But all of our penguins have been sourced in different colour, like green, yellow, or red. Now in the wild, these guys do have a very diet of small silvery fish. Mostly having anchovies. As I said, any kind of small silvery fish they might find. They're probably trying to keep them in the front of the field or swimming in a cliff. Anything they can get their little beaks around. They're all picking up like a stack, another small silvery fish.